Everyone, in this very short video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to import a test package that you have been given from a publisher, typically a test bank. So I'm going to first go into my course. I'm enrolled in this course as an instructor. I scroll down to the control panel and click on Course Tools. Next, I click on the Tests, Surveys, and Pools tool link. Now, you can select either of these, any of these options, but I am going to select the Pools tool because sometimes you'll get test banks from a publisher and they will import as pools and sometimes as tests. So I'm going to select Pools and then select Import Pool. And I'm going to browse my computer and navigate to the little test zip package that I had already downloaded that was from the publisher. Here it is, test1315zip. So I click on that, it shows up in my file name field, and I click open. Now I see that's the selected file, and I click submit. Now if you look up at the top left here, you can see that the little circle on my tab for my browser is spinning. That means that it's doing something, so don't think that it's ignoring you. It says waiting down here at the bottom, and then I get a message that says pool import complete. So that's fine, now I'm done. I'm clicking OK, but now I'm going to click this little link, which is the breadcrumb, back to the Tests, Surveys, and Pools tool. And then I'm going to click in Pools, and I don't see it there, so I'm going to click in Tests, and there I have the test right here. So if I want to open the test and edit it, I can select the drop-down and select Edit. I can modify any of the information about the various questions. I can modify the points. If I want to change the name of the test, I can select the drop down here and edit it. And then after that, of course, you would have to deploy the test by going into one of your units, for example. If I wanted to deploy this test, I would go into my unit, select assessments, select test, select the test that I wish to deploy, and click submit. And then I can put in whatever instructions I need. Be sure to make it available to students because by default tests are not available. Select the number of attempts, etc. Put the timer on, whatever options you wish to select, and then click submit. Now as soon as I do that, once I deploy a test, immediately there is going to be a grade column now for that test in Grade Center. You don't have to create one. So I go into Full Grade Center and I scroll all the way to the end, and here I have the grade column that is linked to this test. So if this is a test that has all auto grading questions such as true, false, and multiple choice, then the grades from the students will automatically appear in this column. So I hope that this video was helpful.